Hello, good evening. You're welcome to Online Healing Crusade. We're so glad to have you. We believe the Lord has brought you, and God is going to bless you. God knows you are going to log on, and God knows you are going to listen to this. I want to encourage you to listen to the word that will come tonight. God has anointed the servant and sent him with a specific word to you, and that word is going to sound not in your external ears, but right in your heart. And if it sounds in your heart, you believe it, you receive the power in the word. We enter your life, and we do just what only God can do in your life. You are welcome. Join me to welcome the servant of the Lord, Evangelist Louis Olufemi Ogunlade, as he comes to bring the word of life unto us again tonight. God bless you and stay connected.
Praise the Lord. Thank God for an opportunity to bring you the word of life. This is Online Healing Crusade. And we thank God for the opportunity to get you the word again today. Now, I've been on a series of With God All Things Are Possible. With God, all things are possible. 2 days ago, I ministered on Matthew 19:26, which says that with men, this is impossible, but with God, all things are possible. And then yesterday, I ministered on Mark 10:27, that says that with men, it is impossible, but not with God. For with God, all things are possible. Today, let's look at Luke chapter 18, verse 27. Luke 18:27. I'll read it for us. Luke 18:27. Hear what the Bible says. It said, and he said, the things which are impossible with men are possible with God. The things which are impossible with men, they are possible with God. The things which are impossible with men, they are possible with God. That is it. That's the word of God for us today now that we want to dwell on and minister on. With God, all things are possible. But this one says, the things that are impossible to men, they are not equally impossible to God. For with God, all things are possible. So things that are physical things, things that are spiritual things, things that are circumstantial things, things that are noble things, things that are mental things, things that are material things, but whatever kind of things they are, some things may be impossible to man. The things that are impossible to man, they are not equally impossible to God. Because God has the power to do what man cannot do. That's why he's God. That is why he's God. He's not man. Okay? We are not talking about man and the ability of man here. We are talking of God and the ability of God. We are talking of the power of God, the anointing of God, the wherewithal, the sovereignty of God is incomparable to man and the activities of man. Are you getting what I'm saying? So if the things that are affecting you right now, if they are impossible to you, God understands that you are a human being. That's why there are some things that are higher than you, you cannot handle. If we are talking of natural things, let's say education, you know, somebody in primary school, in secondary school, in all those lower classes, there are definitely subjects that they will be doing, and it will be very, very difficult for them, very hard for them, you know. Primary school mathematics, secondary school mathematics. Now, those things that are difficult to solve as mathematical problem for grade 1, grade 2 students, is it going to be like that difficult for a professor of that same discipline? No. Because they are not operating at the same realm. Okay? He has more knowledge and greater and better knowledge than them. So what is difficult for them, he will just consider it as very simple because of his higher knowledge. Are you getting what I'm saying? But then, those are physical things, scientific things, material things. If you are talking of money, what a poor man will consider, whoo, this is a huge amount of money, I can't handle this. That is not the same with another human being, equally human being like him, but with higher financial resources at his disposal. He will be able to handle what that man cannot handle at his level because of his financial ability that is low. But somebody with a higher financial status will handle it easily. So it was difficult for that man because he doesn't have enough money to handle it. But it will not be difficult to somebody of a higher money or higher financial status. You understand what I'm saying? What a small community cannot handle, a whole country will be able to handle because of the resources available to them with which they can handle it. Are you getting what I'm saying? So we all need to understand our levels. Natural man have limitations, but God have no limitations. Even men in their different levels, there are limitations that are to men, but other men we can't consider it as not a problem at all because of higher level of accessibility to resources, to funds, to information, to connections and influences. That will make things easier for one person that looks difficult to another person. But in this case, we are talking of God Almighty. Physical things are not difficult for him. Spiritual things are not difficult for him. Mental things are not difficult for him. You know, health-wise, nothing is difficult for him. Okay? Business-wise, nothing is difficult for him. Supernaturally, nothing is difficult for him. And that's the God we are considering here. So when you bring your case to him, don't expect him to be at a loss the way you are, because he is not man, he is God. And the Bible says he is the God of all flesh, God of all being, God of all situations and circumstances, God that is higher than any situation, God that is greater than any man. He has the ability to do whatever he says he will do. Are you getting what I'm saying? So the things that are impossible to men, they are not impossible to God. That's what the book of Luke we have just read said today. Things, there are things that may be impossible to men, but same things will not be impossible to God, because God is God. Are you getting what I'm saying? So now, let's now come to your level. I've tried to use a lot of things to explain. Let's now come to your level. What is it that is a problem to you that you cannot handle? Is it a financial problem you are having? Is it a physical problem you are having? Is it a mental problem you are having? Is it a health matter? What is it that to you looks difficult and impossible? You have heard the word of God today that says, what whatsoever look impossible for man is not impossible for God. For with God, all things are possible. Are you getting what I'm saying? And God is the one we are considering here, that we are expecting to meet us at the point of our need. Whatever it is that you now need God for, we are going to be standing on the word of God, the ability of God, and the power of God to get it across to you. We are not going to be intimidated by informations and understandings and matters that other people have told you are impossible. Because those who are saying that, they are men, they are not God. Lawyers may tell you this case is very bad, there's no way you can come out of it. Okay? Doctors may tell you this thing is so serious, it's beyond medical help. Okay? Politically, somebody can tell you, oh, your case is bad, there's nobody who's going to vote for you, nobody can ever be on your side. You know, where you come from is too small, the population of the place is too low, the kind of people behind you are too weak. All that are talking about physical ability of man. But when God steps into a matter, what things are impossible to men? The Bible says today, they are possible to God. They are not impossible to God. That means they are possible to God. Because God is God. God is not man. Hallelujah. For you are God and you are not man. For you are God and you are not man. He is God, is not a man. What limits man doesn't limit him. Are you getting what I'm saying? And that is the kind of confidence I want you to have today. Because you need this faith that I'm building in you for you to be able to believe when we pray for you in faith. You need faith that talks about the faith in God. Not faith in yourself. Not faith in medicine. Not faith in your pocket. Not faith in your bank account. But faith in God. If you have God's kind of faith, or you have faith in God, you can say to this mountain, shift, and it will shift. You can say to this problem, go, and it will go. You can say to that devil, leave, and it will leave. If you don't doubt, and if you have confidence in the ability of God you are calling. Are you getting what I'm saying? So I am saying all that I have said to build your faith, so that when we pray for you, your faith will have been built up for you to believe the ability of God and the power of God. You see, as for the power of God, it has no limit. It has no barrier. It has no measure. You can't grade it and say this is low level, this is medium level, this is high level. God is always all sufficient God, all powerful God. No one like him. Are you getting what I'm saying? So he can handle all situations, he can handle all matter, whatever level of matter, spiritual, physical, mental, whatever, he's able to do that. Are you getting what I'm saying? So now we're going to pray today. I'd like to pray with you. Having built your faith on the word of God, I'd like to pray with you. And the prayer is to be able to get you to the level you can hold on to the ability of God, the supernatural presence and power of God will reach you right now. Shall we pray? I'd like you to place your hand wherever there is any sickness or disease in your body. Or if it is not an health issue, it is something you have been battling for a long time. A situation that is trying to overwhelm you. Something that is trying to almost tell you that, can your God handle this kind of thing? Is this not higher than God? Since everybody is saying it's higher than them, do you think God can do anything in this matter? So I don't know which one is your case, but I want you to know that our God is able to do what looked impossible to man. For with God, all things are possible. Things that are impossible with men, they are not impossible with God. For with God, all things are possible. So you lay your hand on wherever the sickness is. Or if it is not a sickness, take your eyes away, whatever physical thing is holding you down. And then let's focus on God and the ability of God right now as we pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, everyone and anyone that is hearing this word of God here today, and they have an issue that is troubling them, a situation that looks like so high that is trying to overwhelm them, as if God cannot handle the case. Your word has given us strong faith today that those things that are impossible to men, they are not impossible to God. For with God, all things are possible. So we stand on that anointing for impossibility made possible. Anointing for possibility that can handle every impossibility. Anointing that neutralizes impossibility and bring possibility out of them. Lord, we are trusting you right now. So I pray, Father, in the name of Jesus, anyone that is sick right now, whatever sickness it is, small, medium, major, chronic, critical, whatever level of sickness or disease or infirmity, I rebuke you, devil of infirmity. I rebuke you, spirit of infirmity, that is supervising sicknesses in the life of people and making it such that they will be carrying the sickness from one place to the other. They are not getting solution, but they are not known that you are the one behind it. But I know that you are the one. I bind you in the name of Jesus, and I command you to take off your hand from off the people of God in the name of Jesus. Let the healing power of the Almighty God now flow to you wherever you are. Flow onto your brain, flow onto your heart, flow onto your lungs, flow onto your liver, flow onto your kidney, flow onto every part of your system. Let that anointing, healing anointing of God, like the balm of Gilead, flow into your womb, flow into your trachea, flow into your fallopian tube. Any area you are having sicknesses that looks impossible, you are already being considered having an impossible case. You've heard the word of God today that there's nothing impossible with it. I bring the anointing of that God of possibility unto you. In the name of Jesus, receive your healing now. Receive your miracle now. Receive your healing. In the name of Jesus, stand up where you couldn't stand up before. Raise up your hand where you couldn't raise that hand up before, because the anointing for healing is upon you now. What has been talking to you that it is impossible, it didn't just fly away from your body like a bird. Now, you have faith in God now. You have faith to be able to stand up. Now, rise up on your feet in the name of Jesus. You have faith to walk. Begin to walk. Take up your first step, second step, third step. Begin to lift up your body, because the anointing for supernatural miracle is upon you right now. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Heavenly Father. Glory and honor to your name. In Jesus' name we pray. We are on the third day of this month. I have a word for somebody that is having a financial problem. And God says, I should tell you in the next 2 weeks, 14 days, what looks impossible to you will become very, very possible. Because God is sending you a miracle money. I don't know how the money will come. But within the next 14 days, that financial issue that looks very big, there is no way, put all the money you have in account and everything around you, sell it, you can't make that money. And you need that money for another level of breakthrough. But many opportunities like this have come to you and you are never able to raise the money to be able to meet up with it. But God is saying that He wants to surprise you at this time, because you have heard the word of God that says, with God all things are possible. And yes, God wants to tell you, all things are possible, even financial things. So that money is going to come your way in the next 14 days. Right now, God is already arranging people that will bring the money to you. And when the money comes, remember this word that you have heard, and that with God all things are possible, even financial things are possible. Thank you, Father, the God of all miracles, the God of all flesh. Thank you, Lord. Glory and honor to your name. Ezukabana, lakwa toa nike zuzuya, alashi deleko fleleki sitaro diakawa. How can you just be 34, 33, out of marriage? Who told you that it is becoming impossible? What's impossible? I'm laughing at the devil. The Lord said, with him all things are possible. Marital things that look impossible, God said He's making them so simply possible. Simply right now, because God is making what looks impossible possible. And it will be, the two of you will laugh when you get married. That if I had noticed you, why would I have waited this long? Because God has kept it from this time. And God will open the anointing. And that anointing will break all the yoke.